20 arrests were made with charges including assault, criminal damage and arson. Superintendent Burns says he urged the Football League last June to rearrange the fixture, and now he says they must hold a full inquiry to make sure the weekend's violence isn't repeated next season.
There's got to be some form of inquiry to get to the Football League to ensure that this never, ever happens again on a bank holiday weekend. There's got to be some inquiry with regards to what the Football League are going to do with the now in Division 1 Leeds fans, who clearly are just hell-bent, albeit only 300 or 400 maybe, hell-bent on causing absolute destruction.
David Dowse, the secretary of Leeds United, says the Football League refused to move the fixture. The club appealed to fans not to travel and organised television screenings in the city yesterday, which thousands of fans attended. Only 2,000 Leeds spectators had tickets for the game, but over 5,000 fans made the journey. Mr Dowse said he's convinced it was right to stage the fixture.
I mean, one of my first tests in July is to go through the fixtures, and it's one that started the alarm bells ringing, and I believe the club or the local police did contact the league, and any requests were denied. Obviously, as it came later on, there was one or two mentions of moving the game, obviously from a football point of view that was a bad arrangement to move it because there was so much at stake, and also possibly from a crowd control point of view, because if the game had been moved once the hype had started, it could then isolate the fixture, and you do have the hooligan element from, you know, any other clubs and, you know, other factions turning up, which I understand did happen later in the evening yesterday anyway.
The chairman of the Leeds United Supporters Club, Ray Fell, says the club did everything in their power to stop yesterday's trouble.
I think Leeds United club sets an example to all Football League clubs in trying to deal with travelling fans. They've worked hard with the Supporters Club, we've worked together on it, and I think if anyone is honest and looks at the Leeds United record over the last couple of 3 years, there's been a great improvement and we've tried hard. I don't know the answer to these people. Every effort has been made in the past week to stop them travelling. Again, those efforts to stop them might have invited them. That's unfortunate. But every effort has been made to stop them travelling. If anything more can be done, I don't know what it is. We're willing to look at it. The Leeds United Supporters Club will do anything with any authority to try and stop these clowns from arriving at football matches. We don't want them. They're no good to the game.
The Sports Minister, Colin Moynihan, says he hopes yesterday's violence won't be repeated by England fans in the World Cup. He sees the events in Bournemouth as a setback for English football.
Very much hope we'll see none of that repeated in Sardinia. And for that reason, we've been working now for some 14 months. I'm back out to Sardinia this week to discuss with the Italian authorities every possible measure to put in place to deter the sort of incident that marred the football yesterday and has regrettably brought what has otherwise been a much improved season into disrepute again.
Magistrates at Bournemouth are holding special courts to deal with 71 Leeds United fans, including many arrested after the riot outside the Dean Court football ground. 16 fans have already appeared before the court on charges including arson, wounding, criminal damage and threatening behaviour. Some were remanded in custody until Tuesday at Dorchester Jail, and those given bail were ordered to leave the town within 90 minutes or face immediate arrest. In a rare Sunday sitting today, 30 fans are expected to face a variety of charges, including assault, theft and public order offences. A number of fans have criticised the way the police handled the situation, claiming that some officers had provoked trouble.
All right, they're letting off fireworks, but it's no big deal. They're doing nothing. I mean, if they were doing something, I don't think you'd be here.
They're provoking that. Coppers there. They come running at us down the beach. Smacked me down the face with a truncheon. I put my hand up to push his shield back. Took off my hand off with his shield, like.
Oh, right, police running. Just stood at a bit fence, a bit back. And they just run up the police, shoved me, so I turned around and cracked me on the back.
But the complaints were rejected by Chief Superintendent Richard Durbany, who said his officers' behaviour couldn't be faulted.
I think that any person who was at the match, seeing the hail of missiles, bottles, bricks, posts, fence posts, being hurled indiscriminately at my officers, they would see that this animal behaviour, and I'm sorry, I have to put it as strongly as that, it was totally to be deplored and had to be met with as much force as was necessary to stop what could have been a tragic situation. Now, I think my officers behaved in an exemplary fashion, and they certainly didn't go over the top. They were very restrained.
Meanwhile, the leader of Leeds City Council, Councillor John Trickett, says he hopes any of those found guilty of causing trouble will be banned for life from following Leeds.
I think it's disgraceful. It does Leeds no good at all. I don't know who they think they are, what they think they're achieving by this kind of behaviour. But clearly, when Leeds is mentioned in the news nationally or internationally, it should be for good things, not for hooliganism and thuggery of this kind. And all I can say is, they aren't Leeds fans. What they are is thugs, and they must be dealt with properly. And I'll say this, I shall take advice as whether or not anybody who's found guilty of offences like this can be banned forever from Leeds United's ground.
Meanwhile, national news, a fireman has...